The Philippine Stock Exchange joins its regional peers in the green on Wednesday. The main index was up by 1.14% to bounce back to the 6,400 level. Value turnover was at 10.9 billion pesos. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by John Luis Resurreccion. He is the equity analyst at Regina Capital. John, welcome to the program.
Hi, San. Good afternoon. Happy to be here.
Okay, now we've seen today that most markets have rebounded from yesterday's lows, perhaps assured by the U.S. government's handling of what could have been a major banking crisis. Now, describe to us the sentiment today. Have the fears been allayed? Is the worst over, you think?
Well, earlier this morning, we saw the index bounce back to above 6,500 levels. And as the market closed, what happened is we saw a lot of profit taking, leading the index to close at 6.4 levels. In the U.S., we can see steps being taken in order to handle what's been happening with Signature Bank and Silicon Valley Bank. But if the worst is over, I think that investors are still looking forward to what could possibly happen after this, and how could that translate to our markets?
Yes, talk to us about today's volume. That's 10 billion, more than the usual. What happened there?
Probably during the start of the day, we were hoping for more bullish momentum. And then as the day progressed, we can see more profit taking. I think it's normal. The volume is normal when during times like these that most market participants are taking profits.
All right. Now, United States inflation up 6% year on year, John, and that's 0.4% for the month of February. Without the banking crisis, this would have warranted another sizable Fed hike. A lot of people think that the Fed would somehow be more dovish, but others share an opposite view. Are you still sensing a hawkish Fed given the recent development?
What I think, Stan, is that central bank actions are data-driven. And with the latest CPI reading, it didn't really extinguish the possibility of another rate hike. Instead, it added more fuel to the fire. If we're going to base on that fact alone and echoing Moody's sentiment, then I think that we're more likely to see the Fed pushing yet again the rates higher than not.
Okay, John, let's just run through some of our top business stories for the day. Manny Pangilinan to stay as president and CEO of Metro Pacific Group for a foreseeable future. There's also talk about the listing, just discussions though, nothing final on this aspect yet for MPIC. What are your thoughts on companies delisting from the exchange?
We are aware of the delisting concerns. MPI has addressed this in the recent briefings that with their growth prospects, MPI does not receive interests from companies. The decision to delist is not out of the question for the company. It is still a possibility. If not delisting, they might instead go for a collaboration on companies delisting from the exchange. If MPI does not proceed with a decision to privatize, it is likely that they believe that they are not being properly valued and that their intrinsic value has not been appreciated by the market. The decision to privatize would also allow MPI more control over their company, as they don't have to publicly disclose their financials. My two cents here is that firms going to go private are trying to actualize their intrinsic value, which is overlooked by the general markets. There are names that went all out to convince the investing public to look their way through share buybacks and cash dividends, but to no avail. So hence, pushing them to think that the best route to take, especially in market conditions like this, would be through privatization.
All right. Now, another economic story. Today, we see remittances growing 3.5% higher than last year's figures. That's a jump everyone hopes that can be sustained as we normalize further. Now, are you seeing that this jump is felt, given that inflation is still beating any economic or income windfall for many consumers at this point?
Well, with what I've mentioned earlier, we still see the Fed increasing benchmark rates even further this year. There's no hint of cutting rates yet, So the greenback could sustain its stronger status against the peso. From what I see, with a stronger US dollar, this could propel higher OFW remittances as they would take advantage of the favorable exchange rates. Wager question, is the remittances of the OFWs fell? To answer that, I think that this is one of the factors why consumer demand is sustained. In December, we just reached an all-time high of inward remittances. And this could be one of the reasons why people still spend despite the elevated inflation.
Okay, lastly, John, what do you tell your clients and investors about trading in this kind of market, which is on a downtrend and basically affected by jitters from developments offshore?
For our clients and generally most people who are watching this who wants to invest in these market conditions, what I can say is to protect your capital by making sure to have proper risk management and investment allocations. Also, stick to stable companies that has proved time and time again that they have been profitable and reliable, because these companies, they tend to bounce back when market conditions are more favorable. And during unfavorable conditions, they are generally less volatile as compared to growth stocks, meaning if prices go down, you'll be less affected by the downtrends of the market.
All right. On that note, John Luis Resurrection of Regina Capital, thank you so much for spending time with us today and for your market guidance. Good afternoon.